So friends, now we are going to explain one program. It is another pattern printing program which should print the pattern in this manner, that is, in the first row 1 1 will be printed, in the second row 1 and 2 will be printed, in the third row 1 2 3 will be printed, and the fourth row 1 2 3 4 will be printed, and so on. So the user specifies the number of rows and we are going to print the pattern in a manner as shown in the question. So let us get started with writing the program. As you have seen in the previous video, that we have printed a pattern which was very similar to this pattern, which looked like this: 1 2 2 2 2 2 3 3 3, so like that. So this one is a little variation from this one. It is a variant of this program. So more or less the program will be similar, barring one point which I am going to explain it to you. So let us get started with writing the program. Hash, excuse me, hash include stdio.h, it needs no explanation now, int main. Now we come to declare the variables: int n for the number of rows, I loop variable, j another loop variable. Then we will give the prompt to the user, printf enter number of rows, new line. User gives the input by the help of this line: scanf percent d ampersand n. Now we come to the logical section. For I is equal to 1, I less than equal to n, I plus plus, this is the outer loop. We come to the inner loop like this. For j is equal to 1, j less than equal to I, j plus plus. And after that we are going to write this line: printf percent d backslash t, that is the tab escape sequence. Then we are going to print what? We are going to print j, and in the previous program we printed I. So this is the only change we have done in this program from the previous program where we printed I. So we got this sort of sequence: 1 2 2 3 3 3, like this. And in this program we are going to print the j values. So in this way we are going to see that 1 will be printed in the first line, 1 and 2 in the second line. So these j values will change in the inner loop and it will go on print, the program will go on printing the j values. So this j will be printed over this in this pattern. So now we come to the last line of this outer for loop: printf enter printf new line. So that will take care of this new line. So this control passes to this new line, this output passes to the new line, and so on. So that will be taken care of by this printf new line statement. We come to the end of this outer loop, then write return 0 and come to the end of the program. So let us just study by putting some sample values. Let us again consider n is equal to 2, I will be initialized to 1, I less than equal to 2, correct. We enter this outer loop, we come to the inner loop, j is equal to 1, j less than equal to I, yes, j is less than equal to 1. So j will be printed now. So what is the value of the j? Now j will be 1. So the pattern will be printing 1. So after that j will be incremented, j is equal to 2, less than equal to 1, no, this condition doesn't hold, comes program control comes out of the j loop. We come to the next line, printf new line, we are going to take the cursor to the next line, and now we go to increment the I again. Once again I is equal to now 2, which is definitely less than equal to 2, and we get into this outer for loop once again. For j is equal to 1, we again initialize j is equal to 1 in the inner loop, j less than equal to I, let us see, I value is 2, yes, perfect. We come to the inner loop, print j value, j is 1, so print 1 over here, and then we increment the j value to 2, and which is also less than equal to 2, condition satisfied. We once again come into the inner loop and print the value of j, which is now 2. So we print 2 after a tab, and then we again increment j value, and j value becomes 3, which is definitely not less than equal to 2. So the condition is not satisfied. We go out of the outer, we go out of the inner loop and come to this line to print the new line. The output, the cursor comes to this new line, and we increment I. I becomes 3, which is less than equal to 2. Let us check whether it is less than equal to 2. No, the condition is not satisfied. We go out of the outer loop and then come to the return 0 statement, and that's the end of the program. So we have printed this pattern. So it was the expected pattern, because the n was specified to be 2 and we needed to print this much portion. So the expected pattern was 1 1 2, and we got the output just exactly to the desired or expected output. So this program is quite correct and is ready to use ready to be used in the computer system. So if you have any doubts or queries relating to this program, you can post your doubts or queries in the comment section so that I can address them. Thanks.